Krissy, I love that you're back in Maine.
Yo, what up, though? Calling for Krissy T.
Oh, it's Krissy.
What's she going to say next?
Krissy T in the morning, more like Krissy Unfiltered in the morning.
Maine's new way to wake up. Krissy in the morning on Portland's number one hit music station, Q97.9.
Yes, Krissy, you're on the queue. Let's go. Woo!
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Yeah, I wish I could call my neighbors last night and politely tell them, hey, I'm really happy for your kid that he has decided to take up the drums in school, in band. But there should also be a curfew on practicing those drums. Am I right here? Picture 8 o'clock, 8:30 last night, all the way up until 9:30. And this kid is just going in on this drum set, let me tell you. Now, I have my neighbor's number, but I didn't want to text her. I don't want to make enemies in the neighborhood just yet. I live over in Deering. And let me tell you, if one little thing is out of place at your house, the neighbors will talk. Mm-hmm. The mom will put you right into that group chat for sure. That is one thing I am afraid of, is a group chat with mothers in a neighborhood. There's nothing more powerful. But yeah, so last night was a long one. It was a long one. Lot of drums. Good morning. Hello.
Hi.
Hi, who's this?
This is Gigi. I actually go to Booth Bay School, and I'm not an adult, obviously, because I go to school.
Hey, adults can go to school, too.
But my brother has decided to take up the bass guitar.
Okay.
And he doesn't want to take any lessons on it. He just wants to sit at home and try to learn it himself.
No. And he just wants to go ham on it and just ruin everybody's night and just see if it works.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Typical boy.
And my parents bought him an amp.
No.
He was really excited about it.
I didn't think it got worse. And then it did.
And so sometimes he'll just come into my room and he'll be like, Gigi, listen to this. And then he'll just, like, start playing this random song from, like, the 1970s that I've never heard in my life.
How does he even know about the 1970s?
I don't know. My dad's got him into, like, punk rock and stuff. So he's gone off the hook. He's learning, like, the hooks and starts to every song out there.
Okay, so your night every night is just, like, good God, where are my earplugs?
Yeah.
I miss that about being a kid. It was just me and my brother. My brother would just come into my room, look at me, make a loud noise, slam my door, and then walk away. That's siblings.
Yeah, that happens too.
I mean, do you really have an older brother if you didn't just come into your room, mess everything up, and leave?
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Oh. Ah. Mmm. That's it. I'm not going.
So, Krissy, need you to actually start reporting the news.
Oh, what? You trash. You know you.
You're trash, man.
This is trash. This is sweet, sweet trash.
I don't know, dude. This news is trash.
Like, y'all are so trash. So I'm going to say your name, then I'm going
to
call
you
trash.
I hate that I even have to report these things, but it's a part of my job. It's Dumpster Fire News.
Q97.9.
Yeah, and the first Dumpster Fire of the day, that award goes to me. I don't know how a Jeep Wrangler can do this. It's push to start. If you have a push to start, please let me know. 775-7979. Because I was able to get all the way to work. I had started my car in my driveway. I must have went back in to take my dog out and left my keys inside. But my car still allowed me to drive all the way to work without the fob. Then once I turn the car off, it says key fob not detected. So I can't lock my car outside the studio. And then I can't get home. Hello, ding dong of the day. All right, let's get into a better story, though. An enormous inflatable Santa, and I don't know if you saw this on TikTok, it mysteriously showed up in this vacant lot. Now, this is out in Texas, but I just wonder what would happen if it happened here in Maine. Would we be scared or would we enjoy it? Now, here's the story. It's been up for a week, and I'm looking at the picture right now. It is a giant Santa, and nobody knows where it came from. And all of the neighbors have had group chats. They've all gotten together to talk about it. But it seems like nobody in the town knows where the hell this inflatable Santa came from. But it turns out that they're actually very delighted about it. And their kids love it. So they're not scared. But if you were walking through your neighborhood and a huge inflatable Santa had mysteriously popped up in a vacant lot, no houses anywhere, and you ended up talking to your neighbors about it, and nobody knew where the hell it came from, would you be excited, or would you be like, okay, this kind of feels like it's the start of a horror movie. I don't know. If an inflatable Santa showed up in my parking lot, like here at One City Center, which it did, and it does, this stuff happens all the time. That's just because it's radio. But I wonder what you would do about that. I'd probably like it. I bet you'd probably like it too, knowing Maine. All right, the finale of Squid Game, The Challenge. Do you watch this on Netflix? I'll be honest with you, it makes me feel a little bit weird. A lot of death. A lot of savagery. Is savagery a word? A lot of savagery death. A lot of savage death. Anyways, the finale now is on Netflix. It just started streaming yesterday, so you can catch it on there if you've been following along. But, and I'm not going to tell you who won, but it came down to two contestants, one male and one female, as you could guess. Here it is.
The current prize fund now stands at $4,540,000.
Attention players, 287 and 451. Welcome to the final game. You have both defeated 454 players. One of you will win $4.56 million. The game that will decide that is rock, paper, scissors. The winner of each round will select one key and attempt to open the safe. If the key does not open the safe, you will play again. If the key opens the safe, you win Squid Game.
I could only imagine what rock, paper, scissors, shoot, what kind of game that would be when you translate that into literal terms where you have to fight to the death. It's like the Hunger Games, but on drugs. Anyways, this is the biggest prize money in reality game show history, okay? They just made that history. I'm not really sure any amount of money would get me to play in those Squid Games. What about you? What about you? There's my question. What about you? Would this amount of money be enough for you to play in such a horrible game? 775-7979. Where's my weirdos?
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Oh. Ah. Mmm. That's it. I'm not going.
Time Magazine. Now, yesterday, they just announced their Person of the Year. And it is none the less than my girl Taylor Swift herself.
I told you,
did I not say this yesterday, that she is the most powerful woman in history? And I didn't even know this was going to happen. Look at this girl go. Taylor Swift named Person of the Year. She's on the cover of Time Magazine. Congratulations, girlfriend. You know what? Nobody could take that from her. Not the haters. Not Travis Kelce. So I was able to conduct a very serious interview with Taylor Swift. Shout out to Q97.9 for making this happen. I had to talk to her about how she feels about the whole thing. So here we go. Here's my interview with Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift, girl, what's up? Did you see who's on the cover of Time Magazine? You're breaking history out here. What did you do when you first saw that you were the person of the year?
I check it once, then I check it twice. Oh!
Girl, how do you think all this happened?
Left a small town, never looked back.
Love that for you. We love a hustle in a girl. Now, Taylor, did you ever think in a million years that you would be Time's person of the year?
Never.
How are you going to celebrate, girl?
I'm going out tonight.
Okay, I gotta ask though, what do you think of the photo that they used of you? The one they picked of you for the cover?
I polish up real nice.
And I know you're super close with your mom. So what did she say when she heard the news, or when she saw the news?
I can read you like a magazine.
Okay, fair. That's fair. What else did mom say?
Oh my God, look at that face.
And my favorite question, what are you gonna do when the Karens of the world are gonna come at you and say you don't deserve being person of the year? Okay, one last question, and you can tell me if this is too much and I'm pushing it here. But what could you do to get me on the cover of Times Magazine?
Now I'll write your name. Right.
Krissy in the morning.
Honey came in and she got me red-handed, creepy with the girl next door.
Your shirt's six sizes too small, fat though.
Q97.9.
Well, I think I got to the bottom of Toilet Gate 2023. Let me just give you a little re-up in case you're just tuning in to Krissy in the Morning in Q97.9. Yesterday, I decided to take my curiosity to the microphone. I took my coworkers to court, including my market president, because I'm fully convinced that when we launched Krissy in the Morning, they gave me a brand new studio. I am convinced they knew there was a bathroom underneath it, but they didn't tell me. They didn't forewarn me. They were going to see if I was going to be able to smell it. And they're going to see how long they could get away with it until I complained about the smell. Now, yesterday, Chief Executive Market President of Town Square Media, Sarah Dobbins, she had made her statement. If you remember yesterday, this was her.
This is Sarah. Good morning. I had no idea about the stinky smell. Have you tried a candle?
I mean, we even had our Q97.9 listeners calling out Jad for knowing.
Jad, you're a liar in Toilet Gate 2023.
Have you been listening to Toilet Gate 2023?
I don't know if there's a bathroom underneath. You're the only person that's ever.
Likely so.
Ever. And I used to work out of that studio when it was HOM. I've never smelled any, like, booty, anything. I've never smelled poo. I've never smelled pee. I don't know what the hell
Lies.
You do in your spare time, but maybe you messed up your nostrils.
It's not me.
Smelling your own dog's poo along the way, girl.
The reason you don't smell it is because it's a recent thing. They just put that bathroom in under there, and you knew it. You knew the construction was going on when you hired me back in May.
Order you know what? If I do have any pull on this station, you keep coming at me like this, I will fire your ass.
No, you won't.
Order in the court.
So, I have gotten to the bottom of it, and I have my answer. Security man Dan, now, he has been the night watch man for 21 years. Okay, I see him every morning, and I see him every time I leave the studio. So, he knows this building. I had to ask him. I brought him to court. As promised, as per yesterday, I told you I would find out if there was a bathroom underneath my studio. Security man Dan, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Now, you know just about every in and out of this building, right?
After 21 years, I hope so.
I knew it. You're the perfect person to ask. Now, you know where my Q97.9 studio is, correct?
Correct.
Is there a bathroom directly underneath my studio? Because I'm telling you, it smells every so often. And I think when someone takes a number two, that's when the smell comes up.
I believe it's the trash. Right under your studio is the trash. Oh. All that trash in the back hallway.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, there is a bathroom in Bank of America, but I don't think that's it. I think it's the trash room.
So is there a trash room directly underneath the WJBQ studios then?
Pretty much.
Will you take me there?
I can.
So it's the trash that smells. So, okay, so when I think that it's number two, it's really just trash day?
That's what I think. We have trash picked up every night. Every night. So if Daya's got anything spoiled, it's going to go in the trash from up there, and you might be smelling that.
Oh, my God. It all makes sense. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for protecting us.
The defense
I'm here
is
for something.
Wrong.
How nice. How nice. Right, oh, my God. It wasn't a bathroom. It was a trash room. Good to know that Krissy in the Morning, good to know that my show is such trash. Town Square Media was like, no. We'll build her studio right about.
Say, dance for me, dance.
Krissy in the Morning on Q97.9. I've never
seen. Hello.
Want to know? You're done.
For some reason, house rules, in quotation marks, is trending on the internet. I don't know why. TikTok is a wild place. So when I saw this, I'm like, how can I bring this to the show? So I put it on our WJBQ Facebook page and I asked, what was a bizarre rule that you remember when you would go to one of your friends' houses or a relative's house even? And they had this rule in their house that you had to abide by. I found out y'all are weird. Y'all are very weird. You responded. Let me tell you that. So I picked the 10 top bizarre, most bizarre ones that stuck out to me. And let me know if any of these are you. And please feel free to chime in at any point, because I would love to hear what you have to say about this. 775-7979. We'll do this segment together. I'll answer all your phone calls live. So these are my list of the 10 most bizarre house rules that you, Mainers, have experienced at somebody else's home when you were a kid. This is the craziest one. We're going to do this as number one. Somebody said, and they asked to remain anonymous, so I'm going to respect that, but they said they had to take a bath at a friend's house one time. They discovered that this family had a rule where they had to reuse bathwater. Mm-hmm. Apparently to conserve money or water, whatever it may be. Then I asked how many people were in the family. They said five. They said five people living in the house. They had to reuse the bathwater. So in order for her to take a bath, she had to use used bathwater. That is a bizarre rule, and I hate that for them. I would still be bothered by that, even if I was a kid, to this day. Okay, the second one, I really resonate with this one. My dad used to do this to me all the time. All the time. And I still think, to this day, it's a great rule. But you can correct me if I'm wrong. Somebody said the internet had to be off at 8 o'clock at night, every night. All the websites, all the online surfing, shut off. I think that's good. I think it moderates screen time. I think it's really good for 2023. Another one, the father used to turn the Wi-Fi off at 9 o'clock every night so it wasn't wasted. I agree. Okay, so this one was wild. So somebody said they went to a friend's house, and the rule was you were not allowed inside during the day. Now, I was with this one. I stood with this one until I then read, even if it was dinner time and it was still light out, so I'm assuming this is in the summertime, the mother would just hand the plates out the window to them. It's like the floor is lava on the inside. Imagine that. That is the most intense game of lava I've ever heard. Kind of like it, though. A little weird. This one I'm not really into. A little sexist. Every morning, the females, including the female guests. So if you were staying overnight at this person's house and you were a chick, you had to wake up early, no matter what day it was, and clean the house. Wild. All right. Number six. And you know what, Maine? I would love for you to chime in right now. If you resonate with any of these, if you relate with any of these, and if you want to add your own rule, 775-7979. Because I'm really realizing people got some weird rules, weird ways of parenting. Now, this one is interesting. The parents had a rule that you had to say no, please, after every no. Okay, so, you know, if like your friend's brother is like pulling on your hair and teasing you, you'd have to say no, please. No, stop pulling my hair, please. Oh, the trauma on that girl, I wonder. All right, let's see. A woman says she slept over, and I'm keeping these anonymous. A woman says she slept over a friend's house when she was 14, and her friend's mom would confiscate her phone at the door, even though her father had given it to her for safety. Oh, my God, I have so many questions on that one. I wouldn't stay at that house. If I walked in the door and one of my friend's parents decided to take my phone, I'd turn around and walk right the hell out. I'll use this phone to call my dad to pick me up. You're not my mother. Yeah, I see where my trauma's coming from now. I get it. I wouldn't even give my phone to my principal. Remember those days? If you were caught in your phone, the principal was like, hand it over till the rest of the day. I was like, nah, you can arrest me before that happens. Okay, let's go to number eight. Everybody in the household was forbidden from chewing gum. Wow. That's a weird one. All right, let's see. In middle school, I would go to a sleepover. I would get in trouble for taking my shoes off for entering the house. Okay, so you didn't get in trouble for putting your shoes on. You got in trouble for taking your shoes off. Imagine getting in trouble for being respectful. All right, and number 10. This person said they were eating lunch during a play date, and it was tomato soup and crackers. They grabbed some crackers and started crushing them with their hands over the bowl, and the mom slapped them away and said, you cannot crush crackers on your soup. What? What is going on in these streets? Man, I thought I had it strict as a kid. I guess not. 775-7979. I'm going to turn this over to you. I'm just curious, out of all of your own house rules, if you're thinking about them right now, that you have in your home, Which one would you say is the most important one? And do you have any bizarre ones like this? Would you ever take a phone from your kid's friend or not let them crush up crackers on top of their soup? And if you can remember this, what was the weirdest house rule when you would go over to a friend's house? What would their parents make you do? What was that rule? I want to open up this forum to you because parents, I know you got something for me. Or kids, if you remember the rule. Or hey, if you're on your way to school right now and you want to call out your mom or dad, I got you. 775-7979. Oh, baby. You naughty little biscotti. Why don't you just
meet me in the middle? Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Gotta give it to her. And I told you this yesterday. I've been saying it. Taylor Swift is one of the most powerful women in the world right now. Whether we like it or not, you got to give her credit. And Time Magazine gave her credit. They gave her a lot of credit. Because guess who the person of the year is? Taylor Swift. I am here for this. I am truly here for this. Because whether we like it or not, like I said to you, if you're a Swiftie, you are so excited about this. If you are not a Swiftie, I see social media going in. I see social media going in on Taylor Swift. But, you know, until you can do better than Taylor Swift, you do not, your opinion does not belong on whether or not she should be the person of the year. However, very serious interview coming up. I was able to get a one-off interview with Taylor Swift, and it's very serious. And it's about Time Magazine. And I got the okays from everybody to play it. So Taylor Swift, I'd like to thank you for sitting down with me and, you know, having a conversation for Krissy in the morning on WJBQ. We love you. Here it is. Taylor Swift, girl, what's up? Did you see who's on the cover of Time Magazine? You're breaking history out here. It's me. What did you do when you first saw that you were the person of the year? I check it once, then I check it twice. Oh! Girl, how do you think all this happened? Left a small town, never looked back. Love that for you. We love a hustle in a girl. Now, Taylor, did you ever think in a million years that you would be Time's person of the year? Never. How are you going to celebrate, girl? I'm going out tonight. Okay, I gotta ask though, what do you think of the photo that they used of you? The one they picked of you for the cover? I polish up real, I polish up real nice. And I know you're super close with your mom. So what did she say when she heard the news or when she saw the news? I can read you like a magazine. Okay, fair. That's fair. What else did mom say? Oh my God, look at that face. And my favorite question, what are you gonna do when the Karens of the world are gonna come at you and say you don't deserve being person of the year? Okay, one last question, and you can tell me if this is too much and I'm pushing it here. But what could you do to get me on the cover of Times Magazine?
I'll write your name.
I appreciate your time, Taylor. Thank you very much.
Portland's number one hit music station, Q97. Music make you lose control. Music make you lose control. Krissy in the morning.
My mom trying to torch me right now. Q97.9, good morning. My mom texts me and goes, hey, funny you should be talking about chores. When you were a kid, you didn't like to do anything. Cool, calling me out. Hello, good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm good. Who's this?
My name's Sierra.
Sierra, where are you from, babe?
I'm from Naples.
Naples, okay. So you're a boat person in the summer, snowmobile in the winter kind of girl?
I sure am. I live right on Long Lake.
How did I know?
Exactly. Absolutely. So I had to ask you a question.
Oh, boy.
Because I had this debate in my house last night.
Oh, boy.
And I need to know, what is the one house chore that you wish that you'd never have to do again?
Ooh, that's a good one. The dishes.
Oh, the dishes? Really?
The dishes, girl, because I actually like vacuuming. It's a little therapeutic for me. I like to make the lines line up on the rug. I don't mind Windexing. I really don't. Laundry,
See, for me, it's laundry. I hate laundry. Mm. I wish I'd never had to do it again.
What's so bad about laundry?
You know, it's like grocery shopping. I'm touching the same object a million times until it's actually in its rightful place. And it's like, why? Why do I have to do this like this?
I feel like you're overtired.
Yeah.
You're like, why do I have to keep touching the same dirty underwear day after day after day?
Yeah, it's like I got to move it and then put it in the washer and then put it in the dryer and then I got to fold it and then I got to hang it and put it away.
Your life is so hard. I get it, girl. It's tough in these streets.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
So, Krissy needs you to actually start reporting the news.
You're trash.
It's the trash.
It's the sweet, sweet trash.
I don't know, dude. This news is trash.
Like, y'all are so trash. So I'm going to say your name, then I'm going to call you trash.
I hate that I even have to report these things, but it's a part of my job. It's dumpster fire news.
Q97.9.
Look, I can't call other people a dumpster fire without calling myself out, okay? Call a spade a spade. I am also a dumpster fire today because I made the news. In my own news segment. So I drive a Jeep Wrangler, right? And shout out to Lee Automotive in Westbrook. They always help me out. But I found something out today that I've never seen before. So I went outside to start my car and let the dog out, right? And I must have brought my keys back inside because it's push to start. Must have brought them back inside and left them there. I was actually able to get into my car and drive to work without those keys inside the car. I've never seen anything like this. So when I get to work, I pull into the parking garage and I'm realizing, oh my God, I shut the car off and it says no key fob detected. And I'm looking around. I'm like, oh my God, I left it at home. I left the actual keys at home like a ding dong. There's my ding dong sound. So I am a dumpster fire today because guess what? I can't start the car again. I don't deserve a car after everything that I do. Inside car. But so yeah, now I'm gonna have to have my mans go home and grab it from my house and bring my keys to me so that I can start my car and go home. But isn't that kind of wild? Has that ever happened to you? You ever left your keys inside but your car was already running, so it allows you to drive until you have to turn the car off? It's crazy to me. All right, do you watch Squid Games? It's very cringy, but I can't stop watching it. It's very savage, too. But the finale of Squid Game, The Challenge, it's called, began streaming yesterday on Netflix. So for those of you that have been waiting for the finale to come out, it is out. I've got you. Now, I'm going to play you a clip from the finale because it's pretty cool. It's pretty intense, though. Kind of, the game at the end kind of makes me cringe. And if you know, you know. I'm not going to tell you, and don't worry, I won't spoiler alert who the winner was. I'll let you watch it on Netflix, but here's the trailer leading up to the finale.
The current prize fund now stands at $4,540,000.
Attention players, 287 and 451, welcome to the final game. You have both defeated 454 players. One of you will win $4.56 million. The game that will decide that is rock, paper, scissors. The winner of each round will select one key and attempt to open the safe. If the key does not open the safe, you will play again. If the key opens the safe, you win Squid Game.
Like I said, I'm not going to ruin the finale and tell you who won, but let me tell you, it's very intense. And Squid Games now holds the title of giving out the biggest prize money in reality game show history. Now, I'll tell you one thing. I don't care how many millions of dollars you're going to give me. You could never put a price tag on me going into a ring like that. It's like the Hunger Games. Who does that? And granted, yes, I know it's fake, but there's no amount of money that could make me play rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Because you can only imagine what that is. I'm sure the rock part is hucking rocks at people. The scissors part, I'll let you use your imagination.
Oh, baby!
You naughty little biscotti.
Why don't you just meet me in the middle?
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Okay, I just thought about this. I have two things here. Number one, have you ever had a friend who's been in your life forever and you guys... You can go through periods of time where you don't talk. I'm talking like 6 months, maybe even a year, but you still have that connection. It's always there. You're always going to love them. I have a very good friend like that, Cindy. Shout out Cindy right now if you are still listening. I love you so much. And I always will. We, you know, she was one of my first friends when I moved to Maine, and I was on my very first radio station. So, you know, long story short, we've been through it all. And then most recently, we've been talking about men's deodorant, bringing us together again. There's two kind of girls in the world, right? Girls that use men's deodorant and girls that use it but don't want to admit it, right? Maybe there's a third girl. I don't know. The one that actually uses girls' deodorant. That's wild to me because men's deodorant is amazing. But if you're a girly that uses guys' deodorant because it's just simply better or you have hyperhidrosis like I do, just know you are not alone. You're not alone. Men's products, they just tend to be better. They do, especially for the girlies with hyperhidrosis. And I've talked about this before. All hot girls have hyperhidrosis. It is a fact. And I live by it. And the only deodorant that has really ever helped my hyperhidrosis has been men's deodorant. And when I was talking to Cindy, she's like, oh my God, me too. It's just better. I'm going to go to my phone lines. Oh, what are you about to say to me? Hello, you are on Q97.9. Good morning.
Hey, it's your favorite caller.
Yes, I love when you call. What's up, girlfriend? What are you doing?
Good. I was calling about the deodorant thing.
Yep. See, we all have our deodorant preferences. Go ahead.
So I use Lumi.
You do? Okay, so I have so many questions for you. Do you love it?
I love it.
Does it actually work?
Yes.
Explain it to me. Give me some examples.
So they even have a body wash, too.
Oh, yeah. I think I saw that. I think we run some commercials for them, too.
Yeah. But basically, honestly,
Give me the details. Go,
I
girl.
Use it once, and then I don't have to use it again till the next day. Like the day after.
I just have such a hard time believing that just because I could never. Like, my pits could never. I am, every 2 hours, I'm like a serial repeat.
Yeah, I'm the same way.
Like, I keep it in my purse.
My mom uses it now.
Ooh, okay.
It really, really works. They had a problem where there was a little bit of a weird smell because that is the smell that will kill any odor bacteria, but you don't smell like that. But they fixed it.
Okay, so it was like a recall. It's like a car recall, but for deodorant.
Yeah. but they, I recommend the peony rose or the citrus one.
Okay, suddenly I feel like we're filming a commercial for Lumi. Do you work for them?
No.
Okay. All right. I'll trust you. No, but does it work on like your inner thighs and your butt and stuff? Because someone told me they do. They use it for that.
Everywhere. It works everywhere.
Okay, so what about like lower back sweat? What if we get real deep dive into it?
I mean, I've never put it there, but it works everywhere.
Do you put it on your Pikachu?
No, just on the sides of my leg.
Be honest. Have you put it near your Pikachu?
No, I haven't.
Fine.
I put it on the crack of my butt, though.
Yeah, others call it a butt crack.
Yeah, I have a big butt, so yeah.
Ooh, big booty Judy. That's not a bad thing.
But yeah, it really works.
All right, well, I guess I know what I'm doing after work.
Yeah, they sell it at Target.
Oh, okay. Watch out. She's got all the details. As if I need any more incentive to go to Target and spend my paycheck for no reason.
I know.
Music make you lose control. Music make you lose control.
Krissy in the morning.
This was one of the more wilder things. Is that the right word? Wilder? It was a wild thing that happened to me yesterday in Hannaford. Look, I get it. Around the holidays, people get a little stressed out and then they start taking it out on other people and they don't realize it. I'm the first one that understands that. But I don't know if any of you do this. Sometimes I go to the grocery store with my AirPods in. I like to listen to music and just kind of zone out if I have a big grocery haul I got to do. And I had my AirPods in last night. I wasn't going for a big haul this time though. I was just going for a couple things. So I grabbed a basket and there was only one basket left and I didn't think anything of it. I'm just like, oh, there's a basket. I'm going to pick that up and use it. Well, about 3 minutes later, a chick that I've never met before, never seen before, comes up to me, grabs the basket out of my hand. And I'm talking like grabs this basket. And she's like, excuse me. I should have had this basket. I should have had this last one. You know, I walked in first before you and I saw it and then you just took it. I'm realizing, I'm like, okay, anybody that's going to come up to me and say this is probably not worth the fight. But she's looking at me like, hey, you little B-I-T-C-H, you better give me that basket. So, you know what? I'm too old for the game. So I'm just like, you have it. You go. You have it. And she snarls and walks away from me. I can't make this up. So I wrote a whole letter. If you want to know more details, it's actually really hysterical. I'm laughing about it on the ignorance of this girl, but it's trending right now because so many people have been responding to it on our Q97.9 app. So make sure you download that. You can get all of our trending letters. But this one's pretty good. It's labeled to the girl who ripped a grocery basket out of my hands at Portland, Maine's Hannaford. I wrote all the details for you. I couldn't stop. It was like a little memoir. So go check that out. And you can also find it on WJBQ.com. God bless that.
Krissy in the Morning.
Hi, Krissy in the Morning. This is Donovan. If you learn from your mistakes, that's good. And if you don't, I don't know what to tell you, honestly.
Q97.9. We the best.
Okay, if you've been following along with Toiletgate 2023, this is going to give you some closure. If you have not been following along and you are just tuning in to Q97.9 and Krissy in the Morning, Toiletgate is as simple as this. When we switched morning shows and Krissy in the Morning came on Q97.9 and Lori and Jeff had switched to WHOM, they gave me a brand new studio. Now, the problem with this is underneath the studio seems to be a bathroom because every so often it starts smelling really bad, like 16 canned farts kind of bad. So I'm convinced that when they gave me this studio, they just did not want to tell me that sometimes it gets stinky. So I did some investigations. Turns out it's not a bathroom under me. It's something else. Listen to this. As promised, as per yesterday, I told you I would find out if there was a bathroom underneath my studio. Security man Dan, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Now, you know just about every in and out of this building, right?
After 21 years, I hope so.
I knew it. You're the perfect person to ask. Now, you know where my Q97.9 studio is, correct?
Correct.
Is there a bathroom directly underneath my studio? Because I'm telling you, it smells every so often. And I think when someone takes a number two, that's when the smell comes up.
I believe it's the trash. Right under your studio is the trash. Oh. All that trash in the back hallway.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, there is a bathroom in Bank of America, but I don't think that's it. I think it's the trash room.
So is there a trash room directly underneath the WJBQ studios then?
Pretty much.
Will you take me there?
I can.
So it's the trash that smells. So, okay, so when I think that it's number two, it's really just trash day?
That's what I think. We have trash picked up every night. Every night. So if Daya's got anything spoiled, it's going to go in the trash from up there, and you might be smelling that.
Oh, my God. It all makes sense. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for protecting us.
I'm here for something.
Krissy in the Morning.
Your shirt's six sizes too small, Fatso.
Q97.9.
Okay, before I jump out of here, and yes, one of my friends is going to get my keys from my house so that I can start my car, if you were following that saga. But I want to talk about Merry Madness, because it's going down this weekend on Saturday. And I'm hosting their kickoff party, which sounds like it's so much fun. It's downtown at the historic U.S. Custom House, if you know where that is, right on 4th Street. Now, Merry Madness is basically kind of like a drinking shopping crawl, right? There's so many different activities. There's going to be a lot of local vendors there. I hear there's going to be a photo booth, a costume contest. So come dressed to the nines in your best Christmas stuff because, I mean, if you know me, you know I'm going to be there all decked out. But there's going to be ice sculptures as well that you can watch a demonstration of them being made. So all of these things combined with eggnog, I mean, it's the perfect Saturday fun day. The event is 21 and up, though. So I'm sorry if you're not 21 or you just need to have a really good fake ID. I'm kidding. Watch me get in trouble for that. But all of those details, and if you want to buy those tickets, located on our Q97.9 app. So if you have that downloaded, I think it's trending right now, and it'll give you all the details. But it starts at 2 p.m., and I would love to see everybody there. And if you are already planning on going, shoot us a text right in the Q97.9 app so I can meet up with you and I can meet everybody. But until now, I'm going to jump out of here. Thank you, Maine, for yet another very fun show. I get to find out how weird you are every day. Weird is my love language. And I'll talk to you tomorrow at 6 a.m., okay? Oh, and then I have something for you. You know, if it makes you happy, it can't be that bad, right? Oh, no, I can't find it. I'll give it to you tomorrow. It'll be a surprise. If it makes you happy, it can't